Good morning.
Good morning.
Has Trumbly asked for me yet?
No, not yet. Why are you so late?
I couldn't get out of bed.
How was your weekend?
Good. I finally got my hand washing done. How was yours?
Oh, great. I took up jogging.
I'm one step ahead of you. I already gave it up. Oh, how was your date?
Dates should stay on trees.
Do you ever wonder what it's all about?
What's all about?
Our existence. What we're doing here.
I work here.
I'm serious. Like you're in a perpetual state of waiting?
No.
I do.
Did you see Studs last night?
I always feel like I'm waiting for something.
I feel like I'm in some kind of holding pattern. Like at any minute now, something really big is going to happen and the waiting will finally be over.
Maybe this is what you've been waiting for. Maybe now the feeling is just a habit.
No. I'm still waiting. We're all waiting. We spend our lives waiting. Our days we spend waiting for night, our weekdays for weekends, and weekends we spend waiting to find Mr. Right, and when we finally do, we'll be waiting to get married, waiting to buy a house, and waiting to have kids.
Then when we have kids, we'll be waiting for them to grow up, spending our weekdays waiting for weekends, and our weekends waiting for retirement, and God, then when we retire, then you know what we'll be waiting for.
A stealth bomber costs $830 million. $130 million. We have 75 of them on order. We have people that are sleeping on the streets who don't have jobs.
Luann.
Don't have places to live and don't have food to eat. The Gulf War cost this country $7.3 billion. Why can't this country employ all the money to do all these things? Why can't we take care of the people that are hungry in our streets?
Oh. Another demonstrator. I'll never figure out what they think they can accomplish. I mean, obviously this recession stinks, but...
I want him.
You want him?
Look at him!
In the more than 3 years that George Bush has been president of the United States, he's presided over less economic growth than any president since World War II.
He looks just like a young Alex Trebek. Well, what should I do?
Do?
To get him.
Well, why don't you talk to him after work?
I will. All my life, this is what I've been waiting for. To fight for economic justice alongside my man. What do you think his name is?
How should I know?
Thor. I'll call him Thor, God of Thunder.
La mer, au ciel d'été, confond ses blancs moutons avec les anges si purs. La mer, bergère
d'amour. Economics, Katie!
Yes, it's all so mouillés. Voyez ces oiseaux blancs
les a bercés le long des golfes clairs et d'une chanson d'amour la mer a bercé mon cœur pour la vie.
Bell, don't you think you should get those figures back to Trumbly? You don't even know him. He's probably a jerk. Bill, come on, get back to work. You're gonna get in trouble.
Bell! Have you finished the tax return for BPK yet?
Almost, Mr. Trumbly.
Well, hurry up! What are you waiting for?
He wants to know what I'm waiting for.
Bell, layoffs are running amok in this city. Have you seen the unemployment rates? Here. Take a look at this.
Job and into your arms, to be free, to devote myself to your cause.
In the past year and a half, 1.2 million Americans have been laid off.
And I know just how to do it.
In the 3+ years that George Bush has been president of the United States, he's presided over less economic growth.
What are you gonna do?
I'm getting out of this place.
You're going to quit?
No, if I quit, I can't get unemployment. I'm gonna make myself get fired. Then, at least until unemployment runs out, I can live my life the way I wanna live it.
I'm not talking about your mistakes, Belle. We all make mistakes. It's your attitude of indifference.
Will you cut that out?
Oh, sorry.
Yesterday, I had to stop your letters. Instead of saying enclosed is our usual bill, you said enclosed is our usual bull. What's going on here? Have you suddenly become stupid?
I don't know.
Apathetic?
I don't care.
Consider this a warning. Any more screw-ups, and I'm gonna have to let you go.
You mean you're not firing me?
No. Times being what they are. But don't push me.
One, two, one. Woo! Yes! Woo! Yeah.
1.2 over less economic development in the last 3 years than any president since World War II.
I have to warn her.
Where's Belle?
In the kitchen, getting coffee.
Feeling good. Going. Look at me. Yeah. Woo.
Belle, get down off that.
Yes?
You're fired.
Okay, Mr. Trumbly. Goodbye.
Goodbye. All right, back to work.
I know you're upset, but I did what I had to do, you understand. We'll still see each other. You know that, don't you? Luann, I'm happy. Remember, I did this for a cause. Oh, no. Where is he?
You'll be sharing an office with Luann Spencer. Luann? Belle. This is David Henry, Belle's replacement.
Hi.
What? Somebody, get
that's terrible. Get her off. Do something. I can't have her lying here like this. It's bad for the personnel.
She'll be fine. She's breathing. Give her some room. Stand back. Give her some room.
You slap her face.
No, I can't do that.
Let me get to her. I'll take care of her. I've been trained in CPR.
Oh, my God. Her feet are moving.
Give her a drink.
What?
A drink.
Of what?
You all right?
Get the whiskey out of the drawer.
Go get some water. Go on.
What kind of water?
Hot or cold?
Cold water. Go get some ice water now.
Wait, ice water. Yes.
Hurry up. You, Mr. Trumbly. Go get a towel. Get a towel. A cold towel.
Forget it.
Here's the water.
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 Stand back.
Oh, that's good.
Belle?
Now we can forget the towel.
Are you okay?
Belle.
Wake up. Yeah, she's coming around now. I think she'll be fine.
Yeah.
There. You'll be fine. You just fainted, that's all.
Oh, my God. Oh, she's not breathing.
Look at that.
Get an ambulance.
Give her a drink.
She's okay. She's breathing. Take a sip. Yeah, she's fine.